gold medal game and the one that's been dreamed of. Hull in the middle. Team USA, Team Canada. They got blocked into the corner. 19-18 the shots in favor of Team USA at the moment. Team Canada in white. Ooh, stick under the jersey. And a penalty coming as it hit him in the face. Delayed call on Hull. Off the near side, Simon Gagné. They're trying to move it up ice here. They get it there. They get Lindros on the right and a delayed call. Lindros with Niedermeyer. Shot. What a save! Mike Richter!
And then Niedermeyer, who was the player that moved in, he dove back to jam it under Richter. Mike Richter saves it here. His team will be shorthanded. They're standing. They're applauding here at the East Center in Salt Lake City. Mike Richter with a splendid save. He was spread out from coast to coast. Look at Niedermeyer. Look at Richter have to reach back. Keep the puck away from the goal line. He settles his back on it with his legs contorted under his body. It hit his skate. And oh my, he looked like a gymnast on the play. Red Hall will be in the box. He got the stick up there as you see on Gagné.
It is a high stinging call at 9:27. First power play of the game for Team Canada. But keep that save in mind. Team USA almost forgot that the whistle had not blown. And Lindros just kept going and Niedermeyer joined him and there was nobody else there. And Richter, had he not made the stop, it would have been a two-goal differential. Power play 14 Canada. With all that talent out there, they're 3-for-14 on the power play in the Olympics. Team USA has given up 2 and 18 chances for the opposition coming into this game.
Canada's defense have not hit the net much on the power play.
That's McGinnis, who's got that hard shot. Pronger sends it back. Nolan, Lemieux. And a penalty coming on Miller of Team USA. Korea shot, and there's the whistle.
There will be a two-man advantage. Nolan being checked for a injury that could be more than 2 minutes. Miller gets 2 minutes, I think, not 4. It'll be a two-man advantage for 8. They already lead New Canada 2-1. The stick right there. Up a good call by Bill McCreary. Stick into the face. Two-minute penalty. Careless use of the stick. Team USA in the box. 2 men. Both players used their sticks. They came up high. Both Brett Hull and Aaron Miller's sticks caught the face of the Canadian player. Turning point, key point, middle of the game. Here we are.
Right now, right in the middle of it. 10-19 into this second period. The high sticking at 10-19. This is a two-man advantage, potentially for 8. 5-on-3. Team Canada with a 2-1 lead and a power play with a two-man advantage. With all of this firepower, Sakic, Lemieux. Sakic playing the top. Nolan's in front of the net. That's Paul Kariya. Winding up shot, Blake save, rebound. Fire side, under players, Nolan dug it out. Chelios tried to knock it away, could not, came back to the point. Bob Blake working there, his blast, save made again, rebound, Lemieux! And he hit the post, I think! Lemieux's got his hand up like, what happened? I had the whole net! Chris Chelios. Chelios clears it around the near side. Held in. Wow, what a chance right there. Sakic, Lemieux again. Joe Sakic a one-timer. Didn't get it on net. Rebound came to Richter over the net.
Oh, my. Who else would you want at the side of the net with an open net than Mario Lemieux? Mike Richter with a couple of saves. The puck kept getting away from him, so there were rebounds. He has a really high conditioning level. Mike Richter won't tire. There's the rebound. Look at Mario. Puck's rolling. He shanked it. The puck was on edge. That hurt his accuracy. He looks up and can't believe it. Can't believe it. It would have been 3-1.
Oh, my gosh. 14 on the two-man advantage. Pronger. On the near side. Pronger. Left it. Shot McGinnis. That one went wide. Comes to Pronger again. Time running out on the two-man advantage. Now a one-man advantage. McGinnis. The blast deflected by Eiserman into the seats.
Big blast deflected into the stands. Wow.
Lake Mike Madonna got it.
Yeah.
Pronger in the corner. Now it's a 5-on-4 power play for 40 seconds for Team USA. A very vital moment in this game. They've killed off the two man. Now can they kill off the rest of it? Amati gets it out. There's Mario Lemieux had the greatest chance so far.
These fans in this building are feeling every shot, every pass. They're reacting like the players are.
That's the way it ought to be. McGinnis again through the crease. Shanahan, save made by Richter. Mike Richter had a turn to the right, and Brendan Shanahan was trying to put it in off the short side post. Still a power play. Down to 9 seconds left to go on it. It comes to center.
Tony Amonte hurting at the Team USA bench. He blocked the shot. He stays on the bench. I think he'll be okay, but he's hurting.
They killed it. Penalties are over. 5-on-5. So Team USA gets through a very sticky wicket and an icing here. The game that is for the gold and so much more is 12:50 into the second period as Team Canada's got the 2-1 lead. They could not score, though, in that power play. They had a two-man advantage. They get four shots during that power play, and Mike Richter was spectacular in net. Team Canada in white, putting pressure on again. Lindros in front of the net, trying to get it to him, get deflected as Smith tried to run it in front. Wade cleared it up the far side, held in again, now pushed away.
Canada does not score with a 5-on-3 because of Richter, yet Canada continues. Look at that's Niedermeyer, defenseman in deep. Look at him.
Everybody's down low, including Mario Lemieux was cutting. Paul Kariya's shot, that hit Aaron Miller. Played by Deadmarsh on the far side. Amati scored the first goal. Team USA had the lead. Kariya and Aginla answered. All those goals came in period number one. No scoring here in the second.
In 1980, Jim Craig made the difference in that game with the big Soviet machine. Mike Richter's made the difference here so far.
Mario, he'll turn it on the interception from center. Housley back for Team USA. Had it blocked. Tries again. Comes up to the point. Up in the air. Lemieux will take it away at center. Mario Lemieux backs it up a little deeper to Brewer near side. Eric Brewer from the Edmonton Oilers. Gets the nice pass to Jerome Aginla. Aginla was looking into the middle. Housley wouldn't let him get there. Housley, number six, blocked it. Brewer stepped up, held it in. Hit Simon Gagné in the back with it. Goes behind the net to Housley, who gets it around and out as both teams are changing. Mario Lemieux, eighth all-time in points, all-time. Had that one shank off the stick, held his hands up and said, oh, man, what happened? In behind the net, McGinnis. Al McGinnis up. Chelios steps up for Team USA. Tried to hold it in and did. Scott Young. Young turning. Young. Delayed call coming. Brodeur the save. There's the whistle. Power play for Team USA. The penalty comes at 14:40 to Al McGinnis of Team Canada.
It was just a collision here. As Young moves with the puck, you see Roenick and McGinnis collide away from the puck. McGinnis ends up in the penalty box.
Team USA gets the power play. Here's the chance. It is their third of the game. They've not been able to convert. Down low, Owen Nolan. Brodeur just avoided Deadmarsh to get back into the net. Up for Leach at a point. Leach dropped it off all along. Far side, Housley. Wrister deflected in front. Rebound shot. Deadmarsh covered by Brodeur.
Marty Brodeur with his right leg over the goal line. He kept his left leg out. Deadmarsh had the rebound chance with people all over him. And Marty Brodeur comes up with a gigantic save here. 2-1, less than 5 minutes to go in the second period. The wrist shot by Housley got through. Marty's left leg is down. His glove is above the leg, and he made the save. The big key, too, keep that glove above the pad. Look at his catching glove above the pad in case. Brodeur, who hadn't had work for a while, fights his way and finds the puck. Big save.
Marty Brodeur, the 29-year-old, 12th in goals against in the National Hockey League at the Olympic break. Mike Modano, all in the middle, shot, Rafalski deflected. That went off a stick in front. The defenseman blocked it. Still a power play. Buddy working one of the points. They got Mike Modano in the high slot. Rafalski's open over here. Rafalski trying to set it. John LeClair! No!
chance because it deflected off the skate. Everybody was looking at LeClaire. Madonna makes a pass across here to Rafalski. Hits a skate on the way in. Skater stick right on through. I think it hit Chris Pronger, who had been working with John LeClaire. Released, moved over. The puck hit somebody. It hit Pronger and went in.
Now the other way. Lindros in front. They try to hit Smith. Team Canada right back after that goal. It is a 2-2 game. Wow. Hang on. Niedermeyer able to hold it in. Lindros's line is out there. Eric Lindros, the big 88. Lindros puts it back to the point to Niedermeyer. Niedermeyer's shot. That went through a deflection on Nolan. Save made by Richter. And cleared back to center. The goal right now is being given to John LeClaire at 15:30. That could change. If it stays, it's his seventh goal of the Olympics. Rafalski and Madonna, the assist for the moment. Sent in on a shot from center by Ralston. Blocked all the way up to the blue line. York had it. Ralston came over to help. Ralston got leveled for his effort over there. Ralston gets into a little pushing match. Fireside is out of foot, went right at him. Leach back into the zone, picks it up, and a penalty coming. Jeremy Roenick, a tripping call at 16:30, and Team Canada gets the power play, their second.
Paul Kariya is the player that drew the power play as he had his feet chopped out.
Now Team Canada in white moves it in. This game is tied at 2-2. Closing in on 3 minutes to go here in the second period, and it goes by Blake to center. Power play opportunity for Team Canada and a chance to get the lead back. Blake on the far side couldn't get it. Leach rifles one in high off the glass. Played up the near side. Nolan's got it. Owen Nolan. San Jose moves it in. Kariya Lemieux out there with him. Blake's back at the blue line. They drop Blake one-timer. Save Richter. Young clears.
Well, Richter's had 3 or 4 minutes to get his breath. He should be refreshed and ready to go.
What a second period he's played here. Fireside, Paul Kariya with it. Lemieux set up on the weak side post now with Nolan in front. Kariya to Lemieux. One-timer again. He hit the outside of the net. That's where they want that. Lemieux's trying to just sneak away from everybody and get open, but he's not been able to get it home.
Twice Mario's been set up perfect for the open side, one-time shot. That's his strength, and twice he hasn't been able to finish.
He is ninth all-time in goals scored in NHL history. That one poked into the seats.
Another look at the goal is Mike Madonna with a beautiful backhand pass to Rafalski, and Rafalski's shot, you'll see Pronger move up. He'll try to pass it across, but it hit his stick, not LeClaire. It hit Pronger's stick and went right through. This is why we're on the power play, as Roenick got the legs of Paul Kariya, and there's now 40 seconds left on the power play.
So that tying goal probably will be changed to Brian Rafalski, since LeClaire did not get his stick on it. But in any event, it's a 2-2 game, and again, the puck ends up in the seats. Team Canada having trouble getting this power play set up.
Down to 30 seconds. Faceoff to come outside the zone. It's intriguing to watch this stage and see Mario Lemieux with two different chances to hit the open side and not able to do it. Mike Richter's been brilliant in the second period. He's a big game goaltender, has been all throughout his career.
Boy, has he been here in this period. Jovanovski working a point with Blake, who sends it in. Power play's got 19 seconds left on it. Team Canada gets it in the zone. Jovanovski moves to the middle of the ice. Dropped it to Joe Sakic. Here's Richter. Score!
Second period. Traffic in front of Richter. Nice pass by Jovanovski. Sakic gets the puck just to settle a little bit. Then the traffic. They were trying to work over Aginla in front. Leach is there. Richter moved to his left. The puck went right through Aginla and Neuendijk in front along with Leach. Richter guessed and the puck went through the legs.
Shot by Michael Pekka. Held on to Joe Sakic, who we said came out with some wheels a-rolling, has given Team Canada the 3-2 lead.
Emotional roller coaster this game. It's remarkable. In front of Gidla, strong. Leach tries to move him. Neuendijk will come in front. The puck might even have hit Brian Leach. I don't know. It's 3-2 Canada with the power play goal.
Sakic, who's been an MVP, regular season, playoffs, big-time player coming through here. 18-19, the time of the goal. Jovanovski and Blake get the assist.
98, Nagano. Sackett couldn't finish the Olympics because of injury. He gets a chance to finish the Olympics this time around. Great stick handler. His dad taught him as a youngster to handle the puck back and forth, but never look down with your eyes. Keep your head up. Keep your head up. Taught him that on the driveway when he was a young man, or young boy, actually. And what a player he is. The other player who did not play for Canada 98 because of injuries, Paul Kariya.
And they are both on the scoreboard in this game. Back it comes to Pronger. Team Canada on top, 3-2, out shooting Team USA 27-24. Bragging rights to North American hockey and a whole lot more, including gold medal up for grabs here today. McGinnis back to get it. Fireside, Owen Nolan chases, a minute to go. We're in the second period. Modano knocked it away.
Nolan on the ice here. Eisenman's not on this line. You wonder what Eisenman's knee.
Nolan shot that one high. Steve Eisenman, who's had the bad knees coming in to these Olympics. And behind the net, it is loose. Again, Gendler put the hit on. Played in the corner. Good move. Sakic again was out there to hold it in. Looking into the middle. Sakic trying to find Gagne, who was cutting. Holds it up against the wall over there. Pushed it along the boards. You get a player as hot as Joe Sakic is, you get him out there as often as he's willing to go. Simon Gagne dumped it down low. Sakic, a high stick. Nope. Thought they were going to whistle it, and now they do. Puck was hit with a high stick. Take a breath.
Yeah. 14 seconds to go in the second period. The shots are 27-24 in favor of Canada. They've had the better quality of shots throughout the game. Mike Richter's been brilliant. Brodeur has had work, but not as much high-quality work. Team Canada's been aggressive. They've got the puck deep a lot of this game. And Big John LeClair was in front that led to the 2-2 goal, the power play goal. The Rafalski goal as he was in front. Here's another quick face-off.
Another chance for Team USA in the offensive zone.
Eisenman out this time. He's a great face-off guy, and he wins that one.
Came up, won the draw. Heads back out to center ice here. Sakic stayed out on the ice as well. Theo Fleury with it. Fleury trying to get the puck to stay in his stick. Sends it in on net, and that will do it. We've completed two periods, and for the gold. In the second, LeClair got one to tie it. Sakic got another at 18-19, and Team Canada is on top, 3-2. Team Canada leading it 3-2. Gary Thorne, John Davidson back on top with you, and let's see what happens here in the third. It'll be shipped in by Chelios. Martin Brodeur and Mike Richter, two netminders, both have had to make some outstanding saves at different portions of this game. And you heard Chris Chelios say during the intermission, it's time for Team USA's forwards to get to work here because they have been beaten in the battle for the puck along the boards by Team Canada in this game so far.
Well, the big line, McDonald's line, each forward on that line has one shot in the game, a total of three.
And they've been averaging 10 per game. Not here. Ari Lemieux got it out of there. Over to Brian Leetch on the near side.
Jeremy Roenick's line on the ice. They have played a lot in this game against Niedermeyer and Foote, the defense pairing against Jeremy Roenick's line.
Team Canada's Paul Kariya putting the heat on up ice here. Team Canada trying to get the turnover at center ice, and indeed they do. Lemieux over there on the far side off Roenick. Bounced away to York. Found a little rut in the ice and sends that one in wide of the net. Team Canada holds a 9-2-3 advantage over Team USA in 14 Olympic meetings. That'll be whistled as the puck ends up in the seats.
Keith Tkachuk not seeing ice time. He played a good portion of the first period, very little if any during the second period. We have not seen him early here in the third. Of course, hit by big Vladimir Malakhov of the Russian team early in the Olympics, and he has a left leg problem, a contusion to the thigh, a groin injury. He had an MRI taken on it. No damage from what we understand to the knee, but it looks like he's not able to finish this one.
He probably will sit there for the rest of the game. From the point, foot shot block, rebound right in on Richter, backhand to Richter, got in front of it on Gendler. Jerome Gendler came around from the back of the net. This next goal in this kind of a game is obviously absolutely vital because it's either a two-goal lead for Canada or a tie game, and all the difference in the world in the third period. Moving up was Waite, couldn't get it. Here's Blake. Rob Blake, blue line chance. Richter kicked that one out deep to center. Nieuwendyk dropped it off. Over to get it was Billy Guerin. Guerin has to turn it back. Fleury in, whistled offside.
It went off the linesman's leg, and when that happens, since the linesman creates the problem, he'll blow the whistle for an offside. Canada starts quickly here in the third period. Every time they get the chance, they're shooting away, shooting away. Pucks in front. Richter didn't quite know there's going to be a shot or not, but he still kicked it away. And then the big blast after that by Blake.
Off the face-off loose, Team USA's record of 24 games on U.S. soil. Not losing in the Olympics at stake here as well. They're 21-0-3 in the last 24 games. Olympic games played in the United States. McGinnis trying to block it. Pronger comes back to get it. The crowd, the U.S. part of it, sitting, waiting, anticipating, hoping. Not nearly as loud as they were early on. Team Canada has done that to them by putting that extra goal up. Suter in, his shot, Brodeur knocked her down. And Brodeur will hang on. Adam Deadmarsh with three shots through two, leading Team USA. The other side of it, it's been Rob Blake with four. And that would have been offside, so they just let it roll to center. Hull had it, lost it. Korea took it away.